I'm Tricia Centenera, and let me welcome you to Arrow's home. So over here is our sitting area. We have got a beautiful view that Arabella gets to watch every single night as the sun goes down. So that's quite lucky. These are her fur babies. This is Ryder. This is Rocket. Over here is the dining area. So she wakes up at 7 a.m. every morning and she feeds. She hasn't started on solids yet, but this is her high chair ready and waiting for her for when she does. She does join us for breakfast every morning. So I'm still breastfeeding. I'm gonna take you guys now to Arabella's room. We call her Arrow just because it's fun. So her nursery, the inspiration behind her nursery, well, there really wasn't one. We just wanted to keep it really nice and fresh and gray and white. And the only pop of color was gonna be from the toys and the blankets. And I mean, let's face it, one day your baby's gotta grow up and we just wanted her to have a normal colored room. Otherwise I would have put pink and purple and green everywhere. Her closet is not finished, only because, well, we can't seem to find the closet doors that we want. So they will be coming soon. Her crib is from her titas and various other things in here, like the paintings are from her grandmother. So yeah, so that's her room. Let's go into the kitchen because I'm gonna make you guys a macro bowl. Okay, and welcome to the kitchen. We are gonna be doing macro bowls. So basically what it consists of is vegetables or any kind of fermented vegetables, grains. I like to use a whole different bunch of grains. I'll show it to you. And then it's protein. So today we are going to use salmon. So this is how I do it. Macro bowl, and believe it or not, this is quite a big serving. I will struggle to get through this, and I'll move over and I'll show you how I actually store everything so it lasts for the entire week and it doesn't go bad. While I'm doing this, I'm going to tell you guys about my pregnancy journey. The night before I found out that I fell pregnant, I left to go to Japan to go skiing. So there I was in Japan, 6 weeks pregnant. I was on the lift, I was falling asleep, I couldn't figure out why I was so tired, and boom, pregnant. We had been trying, so it definitely was a conscious decision. So we were very happy about that. And then I was doing Driven on Metro Channel. That was a really big challenge to all the moms out there who, you know, are working through their entire pregnancy and through their whole career and that. Like, hats off to you all, because motherhood's really kind of changed me, because I was organized before, so I thought. I mean, but just look at this. Who am I? What's happened? And when I said that to one of my friends one time, I was like, who am I? She turned to me and she said, you've become a mother. Her name's Arabella. We call her Arrow because it's cute. I think she will live up to her name. She definitely is a straight shooter. She will stare at you, and she's a hard sell. So you can't, people don't walk into the room and she lights up and it's like, oh wow, look, a new person. A new person walks in the room and she's just like, who is this person, mom, and why is she talking to me? She has a very strong personality, and she's not an easy win. And I think that she will be able to stand up for herself, that's for sure. She has a baby barcada. So her baby batch comprised of all boys. So it seems to be that all of my girlfriends who had babies within the 6 months that I had a baby, they all had boys. As a new mom, everybody keeps talking about milestones. And Arabella's only 4 months. So I think the milestones for me was the first time that she laughed. My heart, oh my gosh. It was just the cutest thing in the world. We baptized her at 6 weeks. So that was really important to my partner and I as well, to introduce her into the Christian world. And then now we're on tummy time. So we're pretty much trying to teach her how to roll over. You know, everybody keeps asking me, so I thought I might as well just say it now. Of course I want to have another baby. But, you know, in God's perfect timing, we're not trying, but we're not trying, if you know what I mean. We're letting go and we're letting God. And when it happens, it happens. You know, we're not in a rush. We're really enjoying baby Arabella. And we would love to give her a baby brother or sister one day. But as I said, no rush at all whatsoever. Anyway, I'm going to finish packing all of this up. And then I'm going to tell you guys what I do for me. Okay, so apart from doing the macro bowls, I like to make scrubs. Okay, so apart from doing the macro bowls, I like to make scrubs. So obviously you guys, I mean, if you follow me, you know that I have scrubbed Tallulah, and I'm just basically gonna do up a batch now for you guys. I do make them all myself. So Scrub Tallulah is a self-love, self-care company that I started because I needed a bit of self-love. Because at the end of the day, hosting's gonna end, modeling's gonna end, all these things are gonna end. And I think that it's very important for every woman to have a business or to have something for themselves. So now we have three scents. We have the original scent, we have the peppermint scent, and we have lavender. I'm making lavender now. It's a balancing act of raising my child and nurturing my business. So from not having a baby to having a baby, life has changed drastically. I have Scrub Tallulah and Tallulah's Closet, which I have to nurture as well. It's my own business, and if I don't do that, well, it's gonna fail. So I think that it all just kind of comes down to the fact of don't be scared to ask for help. People are asking me, oh, how do you do it? Being in the showroom, being here. She does have a nanny, I'm not gonna lie. So a lot of people out there are thinking that I do this all by myself. But I have a wonderful nanny who's there for her all the time and is always helping her, always helping me so that I can do these things. And it is a luxury, I'm not gonna lie. But I am blessed and very thankful that she is there with me. I like making scrubs. I find it very therapeutic. And, you know, if a girl buys a bag and she goes home and she's able to scrub herself and it makes herself feel good, well, then I've done my job. But in saying that, I also do that for myself for me time. So I think it's very important for me to get into the bathtub or even the shower if I'm really pressed for time and just give myself a good scrub. Other things that I do for me time is I've been trying to exercise and not get mommy guilt, because I mean it's real, and I try to not feel bad about it. You know, in the morning, in those few hours when she's sleeping, that's my me time. You know, I thought that motherhood would be a little bit different. I thought that it would be a little bit easier but a little bit harder at the same time. You know, one day's hard, the next day's easy, one day's easy, the next day's hard. So she really just challenges me. Challenges me in ways that I've never been challenged before. The best thing about being a mom would be that, oh my gosh, just, I can't even explain it, my gosh. Just the way that she looks at me, I think for me is the best part. The way that she smells, the way that she puts her little arms around my neck. Just those kind of things. The most important lesson in my motherhood journey that I've learned so far is that you have to love yourself. I sound like a broken record, but if you don't love yourself, how are you going to love anybody else? The number one person who's really going to feel that is your partner and your baby. And another lesson that I've learned as well is to take your time and do things in your own way. You know, everybody's journey is completely different. Everybody has a very different way in doing everything. Comparing yourself to other mothers is a very slippery slope. So I'm lucky that I have amazing mothers around me, amazing women who all do their own thing. We all dance the own beat of our drum. And that's what works for us. So I hope that you guys at home who are watching this have that kind of support system around you as well. Okay, so while I've been talking, I've been making a scrub. Pretty much this is how I do it. So if you are buying Scrub Tallulah, it is made with love from myself. You can follow the Instagram page at Scrub Tallulah. And also as well, there is Tallulah's Closet. So I'm wearing a dress, a rental dress from Tallulah's Closet as well. Renting dresses is a very big new thing here in the Philippines. It's sustainable fashion. It's actually helping save the environment as well. So that's Tallulah_Closet. Okay guys, so I hope that you've enjoyed seeing Arabella's nursery, the macro bowls, learning about Scrub Tallulah and the self-love, but I can hear the baby crying, so I've gotta go. Metro Channel, I love you guys so much, but I gotta go. Bye.